Hey everyone, and welcome to Shopify Dropshipping Lifestyle. My name is Ricky Hayes, and today's video is Klaviyo Templates Part 2. So in Part 1, I went into Klaviyo in terms of how to minimize customer service emails with shipping. And I will be including this in this video. I'll provide you a link to this Google Doc with all these templates that will save you a lot of time and a lot of effort, okay? I can't take credit for all of these, but they work and I use them and I want to give them all to you. That's very handy to have. So let's get straight into it. All right, so firstly, you're going to need a Klaviyo account. I have gone into Klaviyo quite a bit. I want to go into it a bit more. Another way of getting lost revenue is, I've gone through it, is DPA remarketing, but email marketing is another important one. Oh, sorry, I forgot to mention, Susie is there. She's happy, aren't you, Susie? Anyway, and basically, this is a form of remarketing. Believe it or not, just a simple email like this has generated me thousands of dollars in revenue where you don't even give them a discount. You just say, hey, you've forgotten to check out, come back, basically. And I am split testing more of that, but this is what I use. I am changing this a bit for a brand, but as you start out, this will be more than sufficient, and you can make a decision down the line. So the first one is, again, really easy. So, and I'll show you all of this in Klaviyo, but I wanted to go through this quickly, is you want to put who it's from first. So you put like, from, I just use the word Sophie, and then space dash business name, because it looks like it's from more a person than it is just a bot. I mean, it is a bot, but you're subtly fooling them in a very kind way, okay? It's not a bad thing. It's just a marketing psychology, okay? So if anyone has any beef with it, okay, don't use my strategy. That's fine. But this is purely just a marketing strategy, nothing more. So your subject line, and I've split test this, and I using their first name. So you get their email and you use their first name. Hey, Ricky, what happened? And then, hey, Ricky, we noticed you were halfway through ordering but didn't end up completing it, just wanted blah, blah, blah. You can use this link. And that's just the code that will actually dynamically update for their unique checkout. They click it straight back to the checkout complete order. As you've probably seen, if you're in my group, Shopify Dropshipping Lifestyle on Facebook, I've shown a little snippet of just of this exact email, and it's generated over $2,500 completely on autopilot. And I am optimizing it further, but this will generate you money. And then the second one has generated me about $700, third one, $300, and then the fourth one, $100. So, the first one will generate the most. But basically part of the reason that these are good too is they have really good open rates. So this, I think, has about a 65% open rate. Now, I haven't updated these, but I would suggest doing so anyway. I do apologize. But basically, just copy the first name and put it in each of the titles. In terms of titles, I mean subject line. So, Ricky, activation required, sneaky coupon, 20% off. I am actually reducing that to 10% off as well. You can start 20% and go to 10% if you want, 15%. It's up to you what your profit margins are, of course. I have found little difference from the 10 to 20%, basically, because it's a matter of if they open it and if they want the discount or not. It's not really a huge discount that will really entice them, I found. So it's up to you. I have been using 20% and it's worked, but I am using 10% as well, and it's working from what I see just as well. So it's entirely up to you. I would suggest actually starting at 10% and then you bump it up. Now, this is another reason I really like Klaviyo, is how it integrates with Shopify, and you can dynamically give them unique discount codes. So you have your coupon code is abandoned, and I'll show you how you do this. You set this all in the back end, and again, you can change this to 10, 20, whatever you want. You just put in the name of your business or some customer service representative. I use Sophie Brown, customer service, and then your store name. And that's it. That's all you need to do. And you just see how I'm repeating that. Now, if you do have issues in terms of copying it into your templates, copy it into like Notepad. I don't know what it is with Klaviyo, but some formatting, probably how I've exported it. So if you do that, put it in a Notepad or something and then copy it in, it fixes the formatting I found. So, but basically you want to do the first one after 30 minutes, the second one after 6 hours, the third one after 24 hours, and the fourth one after 48 hours. Now we set the abandon code so that it expires after 48 hours. So this whole sequence is accurate. So in that 48-hour time frame, the customer's gonna get a dynamic coupon that's unique for them, that can only be used for them, and it expires after 48 hours. And this will follow that rhythm and apply that, okay? So again, you can see the second one, coupon, the third one is sort of reinforcing that coupon to come back and use it. And then the fourth one doesn't have that, their code's expired. And this actually works really well. Can I help? So they actually email you and say, hey, look, I'm sorry, I forgot my phone died or something like that. Believe it or not, I've gotten heaps of emails from this. I'm not even kidding. And because it's the whole thing's been very personal for them. So again, you know, you're doing, you have her name on the each one from Sophie Brown or John, whoever the hell you want it to be, John from Dogs R Us. First name, what happened? First name, activation required. First name, 24 hours remaining. First name, can I help? And they say it all from the same person. They reinforce that it seems accurate, okay? And people are used to this email marketing, but it's a good psychological way of doing email marketing that's not intrusive, and also just get sales. Okay, so I'll put a link in the description for this. Okay, now for the couple of people that have asked about the templates for the other one, although I haven't hit 50 likes, I do want to give it to you all anyway. This is the template that you want to use for your order fulfillment, so shipping and order confirmation. You can just copy this as well, do what you wish with it, but this is the template. Again, just update your website, put a hyperlink for the FAQs, and follow that video from a few days ago, okay? And that's it for that. All right, so I'm gonna show you sort of how you would do this. So if I jump onto this Klaviyo store, so I got the flows, most of them aren't turned on, I've only got the abandoned cart sequence. So again, I haven't updated this, but again, I now on my main store have first name for each. It helps with open rates. As I said, most of these have a 40% open rate, which is pretty good. I am split testing because I'm really building a brand, so I really want to push the brand really hard, so I'm changing mine up a bit. But for you all, this will work extremely well, and honestly, unless you want to change, you don't need to. So the first thing you want to do is, you see how we've got first name, what happened, and then we've got Sophie at business name. Okay, pause. So yeah, you can see here that you turn Smart Send off as well. So you turn Smart Send off, I find doesn't work very well. There's other better ways of doing it. UTM tracking is for when you're really pushing the business really high. That's something you'll start looking into. I'm looking into it more. And then additional filters if you have additional filters. But basically you want to start with this, and you can see how this is. So see how it's from Sophie at the business name, and then what happened, and you just copy this in and that's it. You have that text, they get that, and that'll get you sales. That's all you need to do. And then if we go back, you can see how using that template, all you have to do is add in these timers, the triggers of 30 minutes, 6 hours, 1 day or 24 hours, it'll just update that, and then 2 days. And that's it. And you can see how they're all live, and that's all you need to do. That's it. Now, so you just copy my template, copy the text, and make make one of these and then just spend a bit of time copying and pasting. Basically, these are all just plain text. So if you want to make a new one, just make a new email template as plain text. Copy the details from the template in, and that's it. That's all you do, okay? So to really sort of hammer home, if you're wondering how that works, if we go... I've just forgotten. I think I have to create a new flow. But anyway, just use your flow. Make a new email. Actually, hold on. All right, sorry about that. So you do go into it, you click email, and then you get to this point. You give it a subject, which is exactly as in the templates. You put from, just someone's name, it doesn't matter, and you just choose text-based, and then you just copy it in, and that's it. You just copy it in, and then you're all good to go. Again, it doesn't have to be anything amazing. It's just a starting point, okay? Because abandoned cart email sequences, they do work. It will get you return sales. And I wanted to give you all of this because it is important. It's another form of remarketing that's free. Klaviyo is free for you all starting out, okay? So make sure that you spend half an hour to do this. That's all you need. And then months down the track or something, once things are really kicking off for you, come back, outsource your email marketing, do this, do that. You want to hammer home the email marketing. It is a real legitimate source of income, but you want to start low. And that's why I'm giving you all the tools to start, get the sales, get the money, and then you build up, all right? So let's go back, and I'll show you how to make the abandoned actual coupon. So Klaviyo, as far as I'm aware, is the only one that can dynamically inject coupon. So you see how here we've got the word abandoned, and see how my templates, there's the word abandoned. It has to correlate to that. So you can, honestly, you can name the coupon name anything. You could call it money, you could call it dog. It doesn't matter, the customer doesn't see that. They'll just see a dynamically generated coupon. The prefix you don't need, you just choose the percentage. So you can choose percentage, free shipping, whatever. As I said, I'm doing 10% now. It's working just as well. You can change this on the fly. You just have to make sure that your text and your emails correlates to the percentage or amount off or free shipping. If you do that, that correlates to what you've configured here and vice versa, okay? You choose entire order. You can obviously choose select products, but again, I want all products. Generated codes will be active when they are sent out. Has a defined start date. I don't do that. And you see how you choose 2 days. So that correlates to that 48 hours. And it will generate coupon codes for this discount code will expire after a certain number of days and hours. So they weren't seeing the word abandoned. That's not the coupon code. They'll see some random like 6-7 character text that's completely unique to them. It'll do that automatically. Once you start getting heaps of customers and stuff like that, you'll just see heaps of discount codes automatically generated. So you'll be doing heaps of that with your email marketing. With when someone purchases, they'll get a dynamic code. When someone abandons checkout, they'll get a dynamic code. When this, when that, when that. And if, the whole point is autopilot. Again, I got this idea from someone else. I'm not going to take credit, but I loved it because it's on autopilot. I love autopilot. It saves me time, saves me issues, because I don't want to look at all this crap all the time. I like looking at it, but I'm not going to spend all day on it. So that's pretty much all you need to do to set up a base abandoned cart email sequence. Okay, I do suggest you set up a newsletter sign up as well. It has the flow there. Just change it, put a discount code, 10% or something to incentivize them. And it doesn't have to be amazing. Your abandoned cart sequence and your newsletter are your two probably most important ones you want to set up to begin with. Start with your abandoned cart and then work on your newsletter one. Just jump in there, change some text, make it sort of unique to your business, your brand, throw in a discount code, 10%, let's say. Put them on live. They don't have to be perfect. People will sign up for your newsletter, whether it's through Wheelio, Privy, or just your newsletter down the bottom in your footer, and you will get some sales from that. And that's all you need to do, okay? So that's pretty much it from today's video. Again, I am trying to tailor my videos more to what I'm seeing is the day-to-day needs of the group. of my group. Sorry, it's not my group. It's a community. Sorry. Of Shopify dropshipping lifestyle. I really am trying to hammer home making this something that will meet your needs throughout your journey, okay? I'm trying to make my videos a bit shorter as well, because one, for me, time's a bit strict, but two, make it more condensed so that you have more time in your day to make money. So please, if you like today's video, drop a like, drop a comment below if you're happy with today's video, if you have any feedback, if you want us, what you want to see in the future in terms of videos. Again, there's Instagram influencers is one that's definitely coming up. I've got, I can't actually remember. I always forget this part. I've got a heap of ideas, but I always sort of forget. I am going to do another store review video and a lot of other things in the line, but honestly, just right now, I actually just keep forgetting. But don't forget to hit the subscribe button and the notifications so you get updated as soon as I upload a video. And don't forget to join my Facebook group, Shopify Dropshipping Lifestyle. And there's a cheat sheet in the description below. Completely free, just a cheat sheet that will get you started. That's just something that you can use to help you on your journey as well. So don't forget to download that. That'll help you as well, all right? But the community has grown so rapidly, nearly 800 members, and I'm sort of, wow. And I am so close to 500 subscribers. I was like, I think I'm 10 subscribers off. So give me subscribers, I want to hit 500. I'm pretty proud of that. But that's all from today's video, everyone. Until tomorrow, thank you very much for your time and have a lovely day.